miles an hour is required to keep those cars up on the banking. Those presidential limousines, which are built on truck chassis, weigh about 22,000 pounds, will probably not be doing 70 through the 31-degree banking of turns 1 and 2. But we'll stay down on the apron.
Now, you think when he finishes this lap, is he going to do a burnout? What kind of horsepower is underneath the hood of that car?
Well, Jeff Harra, Fox Graphic Department, came up with a comparison between the NASCAR Cup cars and what Secret Service calls the beast, the presidential limousine, built by Cadillac on a truck chassis with Cadillac sheet metal. It's 2 feet longer than the Cup car, and it's a little heavier at 22,000 pounds. Horsepower and top speed is sufficient, but unknown. It's been estimated that those side windows are 5 inches thick of bulletproof glass and that the sheet metal is some 8 inches thick as it's fully armored. And, of course, seating capacity 7 for the limo and 1 for our Cup cars.
Only thing I wish they'd have modified on that limo is put a spoiler on that rear deck lid. Just for NASCAR.
Well, it does have a couple of antennas for communication, after all. Not sure what those flags on the front fender are going to do for aerodynamics. Nor do we care. Donald Trump is the 4th sitting United States president to attend a race here. Ronald Reagan gave the command to start from Air Force One and was here when Richard Petty drove to his 200th victory over Cale Yarborough in a Firecracker 400. George H.W. Bush, the summer of 92, and George W. Bush, the 2004 Daytona 500. Bill Clinton campaigned at Darlington at a NASCAR race, but the president with the closest ties to the sport was Jimmy Carter. One of Jimmy's closest friends in Georgia when he was governor was Alf Knight, the longtime superintendent of Atlanta Motor Speedway. Jimmy would come down, be a visitor to the track often, and was honorary starter for a race there when he was governor. Someone on Twitter took a picture of the presidential limousine and emblazoned a NASCAR-style number 45 on the door, but that idea was rejected in favor of the presidential seal.
But we know these race fans, they've been ready all week. They're super excited, waving flags of their favorite driver, but I gotta imagine there's a lot of American flags waving out there right now as we get ready to take the green flag here.
And if you're a fan of professional cars, limousines, and the like, there is a great exhibit of presidential limousines of the past at the Henry Ford Museum in Dearborn, Michigan. And a big roar from the crowd as they come past. The green and American flags are waving.